That's so cool. Yeah. I didn't know that was going to happen.
We have any former paratroopers, any airborne guys here present? There you go. Raise your hands. Airborne. We'll ask those former airborne guys to volunteer for next year. Still do it, guys? Ah, they're laughing.
That camera thing is coming again.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
That is so cool.
Yeah, I wish I am. He's getting bigger.
Yeah, because he's just
It's going to land right over here.
He's tiny.
I think we can applaud louder than. How about a big loud cheer? Yeah. Salute. Now we have the procession of fallen heroes for those who have came, who made the ultimate sacrifice, the escort of the casket taken by the Legion Riders.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket around. Through the night that
Of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would you join me in prayer as we remember those who have served our country faithfully and for their families as well? Would you join me in prayer? Father, as we gather here today remembering those who have served and who are serving our country in the armed forces, we stand in silence and respect for all who have paid the ultimate price for our freedom. Not just for them, but we remember those that are prisoners of war, those that are missing in action, those that are suffering from different types of war injuries. We not only remember them, but also their families as well that are left behind. We ask that you would comfort these families and help them. Help us never to forget their sorrow and the hurts that they still have within their hearts. Heal their hearts, their minds, because we know that you are the great physician and the good shepherd of the heart. We pray for those who have fought for our freedom, whose bodies and whose spirits are still scarred by war, whose minds are haunted by the memories of war, heal them not only today during this time as we remember them, but also in the days to come. As we remember the past, help us never to forget those that are serving today. As we honor them, remembering them who are in harm's way. Watch over them, keep them in your care. Bring them home safely. And let this time, as we remember those individuals, let those times be remembered in our hearts and our minds in the days to come. Help us not to forget. For I pray this and ask this in Jesus' name. You may be seated. Your particular song is played. Please stand to be acknowledged. Okay, thank you. Thank you.
I'm here representing Congresswoman Julie Brownlee. I am an Air Force and Navy veteran and a surviving spouse. She's very sorry that she was unable to attend today and asked that I read to you a letter that she had prepared for this event. We come together to honor the lives of those who have fallen for the rights, liberties, and protections we so often take for granted. In their memory, we come together to pay our respects and give thanks for their sacrifice. To all of the members of our military, serving at home or abroad, we are grateful for your service. To our veterans, know that your sacrifices do not go unnoticed. On this day of remembrance, let us reaffirm our commitment to these men and women, both past and present. As the daughter, sister, and niece of men who have served, I remain committed to ensuring that the over 40,000 veterans in Ventura County and the over 20 million veterans in the United States.
It is my honor to be here again to, I don't know if we can say celebrate, but certainly to memorialize and appreciate and show our respect to those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. This is, after all, Memorial Day. And each and every person who has given that ultimate sacrifice so that the next generation could have the opportunity to live freely. So I want to thank all of you for being here, for the soldiers who are having difficulty standing up to salute their branch of government because they served in World War II. And we know 70 years ago, in just a few weeks, will be the ultimate deciding battle in Europe. When we had D-Day on the coast off of France, and the thousands of men who gave their lives to end that horrible war. Thank you on behalf of all of us in the state of California. Thank you to all of you who continue to remember those people and continue to fight so that we don't have to fight anymore. Thank you.
District, and I also have the honor of being the chair of the Veterans Committee for the Assembly. The half-staff position on Memorial Day commemorates the more than 1 million men and women who have given their lives in service to our country. At noon, when we return the flag to half-staff, full-staff, their memory is raised by the living who resolve not to let their sacrifice be in vain, but to rise up in their stead. Celebrate the men and women of our armed forces who understand that any minute they might be the person we are remembering on future Memorial Days, yet they continue to serve. Celebrate our veterans who come home and give a hand so that we may all live free. Thank you.
Who have served our country and who continue to serve our country. I'm grateful for the opportunity to take this moment today to pause to demonstrate strength and resolve in their homes and our community while they're without the comfort of having their loved ones nearby. We recognize that many of our military families give unwavering support for their loved ones whom served and those that are serving, and they are truly our unsung heroes, and we wish to thank them also. Today we also have a recognition on behalf of the Board of Supervisors to Conejo Mountain Funeral Home, Memorial Park, and Crematory for their, this is their 5 decades of this wonderful service, and in deep appreciation. Thank you.
As Mayor of Camarillo, I'm invited to a great number of events and celebrations, meetings during the course of my duties. I cannot think of a greater honor than to be asked to participate in a Memorial Day program which we remember those who died in defending our nation. The need for a strong, well-trained military is absolutely essential. As individuals, we need to constantly remind our elected federal officials of this need and urge them support as much as we support the military. We can also express our appreciation and thanks to those military personnel stationed in Ventura County whom we might encounter. It is a small gesture, but it will mean a lot. We should do the same for our many retired veterans living in Camarillo and Ventura County. They also deserve our thanks, and I particularly want to thank those that are here today. Some 150 years ago, following the close of the Civil War, citizens from both the North and the South gathered in cities and towns to decorate the graves of their young men who had fallen under the tanks. Thank you for attending this event
and accomplishments. And I will just highlight the main ones that he was, which is always interesting and important. He's 18 years of age when he enlisted in the United States Marine Corps and served 21 years in service of his country, the United States Marine Corps. So it's my honor and my privilege to introduce to you this morning our keynote speaker, Master Sergeant Stephen A. Williams, United States Marine Corps, retired.
Senator Hannah Beth Jackson, we welcome her along with Assembly Member Jackie Irwin, County Supervisor Kathy Long, Mayor Bill Little, active duty military personnel, and veterans alike, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 50th annual, lest we forget, Memorial Day service, and thank you for attending today's ceremony. It is indeed a privilege and an honor for me to be here and speaking with you this morning on such an important occasion. Today, we're here to honor our heroes, and as I look out, I see that flag representing the prisoners of war and missing in action. We remember their achievements, their courage, and we say thank you for the sacrifices. In thanking those who joined us today, and those who are here in spirit, one cannot help but feel awed on the enormity of such an occasion, the one that we encounter here today. We stand in the midst of patriots and the family and friends of those who nobly served our country. Today, Americans from all backgrounds and corners of our country serve with valor, courage, distinction, in the United States Armed Forces. Many of today's warriors, they know what it means to lose a friend too soon, and all of our service members and their families understand all too meaning, the true meaning of sacrifice. This Memorial Day, we express our deepest appreciation to the men and women in uniform who gave their last full measure of devotion to this country so that we might live in freedom. There are those of us who cherish this. We cherish their memory and pray for the peace that they laid their lives down for. For others, Memorial Day, well, it's come to signify the start of summer. It's often celebrated with cookouts, family get-togethers, road races, concerts, and the like. But the real meaning of Memorial Day has, for too many Americans, I feel, gotten lost in all the holiday hoopla. So, who is Memorial Day for? Well, it's for all of us. In fact, it's for all Americans to remember the many freedoms that we enjoy because of the brave few who dedicated their lives to this country and who died much too soon from wounds seen and unseen. Many in this country are easily confused by the various holidays honoring our military service members. I mean, there's a holiday for those that have served, Veterans Day, those that are serving now, Armed Forces Day, and those who died in service to this nation, Memorial Day. Add to that an array of birthdays for the various armed forces, Flag Day, Independence Day, and the like. And it becomes quite clear that this country has an abundance of opportunities to appreciate all who contribute to our nation being free and secure. This was not always the case for previous generations, and many heroes went to their graves unmarked and unnoticed by history. It is indeed a blessing to now have so many forms to express our gratitude, and what a gift it is to have a country where less than one half of 1% actually serve on active duty and have such a small percentage produce so many heroes to celebrate and to honor. This is what makes America, in the words of President Lincoln, the last best hope on earth. In fact, Memorial Day continues to attest to the world how we as a nation honor the men and women who pledged their lives to protect Americans against all enemies, foreign and domestic. A nation truly reveals itself, as President Kennedy once said, not only by the men and women it produces, but also by the men and women it honors and remembers. So at this time, I'd like to ask that the service members and veterans who are here in the audience to please stand at this time. Forces the most respected in the world. Now, I'd like to ask that the family members of any service member to please stand at this time. Again, that would be the family member of any service member to please stand. Taking the heavy load to keep the home fires burning. We appreciate you and we thank you. Since the founding of our nation, America's sons and daughters have given their lives in service to our country, from Concord and Gettysburg to Marne and Normandy, Inchon and Quezon, Baghdad and Kandahar. They departed our world as heroes and gave their lives for a cause greater than themselves. Abraham Lincoln, during his Gettysburg Address, delivered during the same war that would give rise to this holiday, Memorial Day, stated, "It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave their last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, have a new birth but freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, and for the people, shall not perish from the earth." Unquote. The service members we honor today, well, they came from all walks of life. You know, but they shared several fundamental qualities: courage, dignity, determination, selflessness, dedication to duty, and integrity. All the qualities needed to serve a cause larger than oneself. They didn't ask to leave the home fronts. They didn't ask to fight on distant battlefields. And as in years past, many of them didn't even volunteer. And yet, they certainly went to war, but they didn't go to war because they love fighting. They were called to be part of something bigger than themselves. They were ordinary people who responded in extraordinary ways in extreme times. They rose to the occasion because they wanted to protect a nation which had given them and us so much. When the men of the Army's 9th and 10th Cavalry Regiments served at Fort Sill, Oklahoma during the Indian Wars, they were given the most difficult duties under the most rigorous circumstances. Their bravery was legendary. Their fabled unit became one of historic cornerstones of the armed forces. Today we read of the valor that these soldiers displayed, the challenges they overcame, and only secondarily do we notice the root of the regimental nickname, the Buffalo Soldiers, a name given them by an enemy fascinated with their dark skin and their hair. During World War II, when the nurses on Corregidor stayed on to tend to the wounded, they knew what was facing them. Inevitable hardship, possible death. They'd be captured, imprisoned, tortured, and some even killed. But they never faltered, and not one man, from General Douglas MacArthur on down, questioned their right to stay behind. But they did. They were soldiers. That was the mission, and they carried it out. At the end of the war, they were freed from the prison camps, and indeed, indeed, many of them died. They were warriors, and they were heroes, and they also happened to be women. While serving with Marine Medium Helicopter Squadron 263, Marine Aircraft Group 16, 1st Marine Aircraft Wing, Fleet Marine Force Pacific in the Republic of Vietnam on January 31st, 1970, a private first class Raymond Clausen participating in a helicopter rescue mission to extract several members of a platoon who had inadvertently walked into a minefield while attacking enemy positions, PFC Clausen skillfully guided his helicopter pilot into a safe landing in an area cleared by one of the mine exploding. With 11 Marines wounded, one dead, and the remaining 8 Marines holding their position for fear of detonating other mines, PFC Clausen quickly leaped from the helicopter and, in the face of enemy fire, moved across the extremely hazardous mine-laden field, carrying casualties on his back to a waiting helicopter and then placing them aboard. And despite ever-present threat of further mine explosions, continued his valiant efforts, leaving the comparatively safe area of that helicopter 6 more times. On one occasion, while he was carrying one of the wounded, another mine detonated, killed a corpsman, wounded 3 others. Only when he was sure that everybody was safely back on board that helicopter did he go ahead and have that pilot depart the landing zone. In 1993, an Army helicopter crashed in the middle of a dense maze of shacks and shanties. You might remember this. It was in Mogadishu, Somalia. A growing number of enemy troops were closing in on the site where 4 critically wounded soldiers were trapped in the wreckage of the helicopter. A Master Sergeant Gary Gordon and Sergeant First Class Randall Shugart volunteered to leave their base camp to go to the aid of their fallen comrades. They didn't have to do that, but they volunteered. Subjected to intense fire from automatic weapons and rocket-propelled grenades, they fought their way through very narrow streets to the crash site. When they got there, they stayed, they fought, and they fought until their ammunition was exhausted. After Sergeant Shugart was killed, Master Sergeant Gordon took a rifle from the debris that he found laying there, gave it to the last pilot that was there, looked him in the eye, and wished him good luck, and continued to fight until he himself was fatally wounded. These courageous men and women, each so different in heritage, each so different in their backgrounds, share the common bonds of the armed forces. Duty, sacrifice. All of them reached a moment in their lives when race, religion, creed, and color made absolutely no difference whatsoever. What remained was the essence of America, the fighting spirit of a proud, valorous people. They were soldiers, Marines, sailors and airmen who paid the ultimate price for freedom. As we remember these brave warriors and their comrades, on this day, Memorial Day, we look to the future, and then we look to the past. Today's world, freedom comes cloaked in uncertainty. You see it every day. America will still rely on her sons and her daughters to defend her liberty. The cost of independence remains high, but we're willing to pay it. We don't pay it gladly, but we pay it with deep reverence and with thanks. We know that in the years to come, more brave souls will sacrifice their lives for America, and we include them in our thoughts and our prayers today. For the families of the fallen, we mark this Memorial Day with Pride of Remembrance Act, creating a White House commission to encourage the people of the United States to give something back to their country, a country which provides them with everything, with freedom, opportunities. As in years past, the National Moment of Remembrance Commission again encourages all of us, all Americans, to stop what we're doing, to pause for a moment at 3 p.m. this afternoon. A moment of silence to remember, to honor those who fell in the service to this nation. So in closing, I ask you again, who is Memorial Day for? It's for every one of us who needs to remember and for those of us who will never forget. Thank you for attending today. God bless you. God bless your families. God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you. Apostle Paul wanted to encourage a young pastor going into the ministry, and he gave him these words: I have fought a good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Will you join me in prayer? Father, at this time we come to a time remembering those who have served our country. Help us to continue to remember them and those that are serving even today. Encourage them when they are discouraged. Give them hope when they are lonely. Assure them that we as a nation are grateful for their service and their sacrifice. Defend them as they have defended us. Give them courage each day to faithfully do their task. And when they walk through the valley of the shadow of death, and their families as well, watch over them. Be with them as you have promised that you would. Give us as Americans hearts of gratitude for those that are on the front lines. Watch over them and their families, and give them strength each day. And give our leaders good judgment to make the right decisions for not only those that are serving our country, but for those that are left behind as families. And keep us all mindful of how brief life really is, and to prepare our hearts for eternity. As our soldiers stand ready to defend us, help us to stand ready to serve and support them in any way that we can. Thank you for their service. Thank you for their lives. And thank you for our freedom. And watch over us as we go our separate ways, remembering what this day is really about.
Pipe Band, I think it would be appropriate to acknowledge everyone who made this day possible. First of all, the back of your program.